Hi guys. Today we will analyze Mastercard stock and calculate its intrinsic value using two different valuation models. Enjoy. Hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. Technical analysis. Both the short-term and long-term trends are neutral, so this is not the most entertaining stock around. Support level is around $330, then $308. Resistance level is around $383. If the stock breaks that level, it may go up to $395, and even higher. Prices have been rising strongly lately. It may be a good idea to wait for a consolidation or pullback before considering an entry. Intrinsic value. Buy low, sell high. We have heard it many times before. But how to know when it's low and when it's high? The intrinsic value of a stock is its true value. It refers to what a stock is actually worth, even if some investors think it's worth a lot more than that amount. Intrinsic value is important because it can help investors understand whether the cost of a stock is undervalued or overvalued compared to the market value of the stock. Let's calculate the stock's intrinsic value. For more accurate results, we will use two different valuation models to calculate the intrinsic value of the stock. Discounted free cash flow model, using the formula below, then valuation based on earnings per share, 5-year average PE ratio and expected growth rate. First model, discounted free cash flow valuation. This spreadsheet contains some financial data that we will use for the stock valuation. We see that the average revenue growth rate of the stock has been around 13% per year for last 5 years. Also, we see that the average profit margin of the stock has been around 41% per year for last 5 years. Also, we see that the average free cash flow to net income rate of the stock has been around 109% per year for last 5 years. And we expect 8% per year average stock market return. Now, let's consider three different scenarios for Mastercard Company: bad, average, and good. First scenario. Mastercard will have bad performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future revenue growth rate would be low, 6%. Future profit margin would be low, 34%. Future free cash flow to net income rate would be low, 100%. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $150. The second scenario. Mastercard will have average performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future revenue growth rate would be average, 8%. Future profit margin would be average, 40%. Future free cash flow to net income rate would be average, 110%. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $202. The third scenario. Mastercard will have high performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future revenue growth rate would be high, 10%. Future profit margin would be high, 46%. Future free cash flow to net income rate would be high, 120%. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $267. Second model, valuation based on earnings per share. This spreadsheet contains another financial data that we will use for the stock valuation. The current earning per share price for Mastercard is 8.76. Minimum rate of return. I will use 12%. Because when we invest in individual companies, we are looking for a higher return than the S&P 500. For Mastercard, analysts forecast growth rate around 26.61% per year in next 5 years, and future PE around 36. Again, I will use three different scenarios for Mastercard Company: bad, average, and good. First scenario. Mastercard will have bad performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future growth rate would be low, 6%. Future PE would be low, 30. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $160. Second scenario. Mastercard will have average performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future growth rate would be average, 8%. Future PE would be average, 33. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $208. Third scenario. Mastercard will have high performance in next 5 years, and we will use the following parameters in our calculation. Future growth rate would be high, 10%. Future PE would be high, 36. In this case, the fair value of the stock today would be $268. As you can see, today the stock is overvalued, $382, even if we expect MasterCard's high performance in future. The fundamentals are good. But the stock is very overpriced. I own this stock, and I would be happy to buy more when it drops below $250. Company's strengths. MasterCard operates the world's second largest electronic payments network, providing processing services and payment product platforms. The management emphasized significant opportunities in the areas of commerce, accelerated digitization, new commerce, society, payment modernization, and technology, cybersecurity, AI and analytics, digital currencies. MasterCard has a return on assets of 22.86% and return on equity of 120%. This is amongst the best returns in the industry. Profit margin of 45% is amongst the best returns of the industry. Based on estimates for the next 5 years, MasterCard will show a strong growth in revenue. The revenue will grow by 18% on average per year. MasterCard is expected to show a strong growth in earnings per share. In the coming 5 years, the EPS will grow by 25% yearly. Risks. The company faces considerable competition in the payments market from well-established brands, including Apple Pay, Visa Checkout, PayPal and American Express's Later Pay services, as well as other digital products from Facebook and Google. MasterCard faces risks from regulation, including rules capping interchange reimbursement rates, as well as from economic variables that could impact service revenues, data processing fees, and cross-border transaction fees. Geopolitical factors, which could result in business disruption, are also a risk. The PE ratio is 43, which means the current valuation is very expensive. Compared to an average industry debt-to-equity ratio of 0.23, MasterCard requires more financing than its industry peers. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel.